Hey everyone, welcome, Keeper, Wicked, wouldn't feel like a stream without you guys. Great seeing you here, and you know, hopefully some of our other homies will be joining us soon. Got a few different things I'm going to get into today, some of which aren't these jackets that you're seeing. This is something that for another project. Let me check the camera. Uh-oh, I gotta get my lighting straight. That looked all weird. That didn't help that much. Okay, my light seems to be a little... Well, my camera doesn't like my lighting very much. That's kind of funny. Wait, whoa, that's not bad. If I'm way back here... Oh... I think it might be because I'm too close to one of the other sources here. Give me a second. It's funny, yeah, there it goes. Now it calibrated. Because I just did a fucking check. I'm just like, what? This is bullshit. I just checked it right before going on. Let me see if I can get this out of my eyes now. Let's see. Alright, it's a little better. This is what I mean. Like, by not always wanting to do the camera thing. It has nothing to do with me worrying about, like, show my face. Is this like fucking lights? You know what I mean? Like, shit behind you, you know? All that kind of stuff. Mine went worse. I think I am bugging it out though because of my shirt. So that's kind of on purpose too. But either way. What the fuck am I gonna do? Oh yeah, I'm gonna open up something, create a fun thing, because it is an example of using the sphere tool or the circle tool in Voxedit now. I dig it, it's cool, you know, pretty much what I expected. And what I find, I use more these days, out of all the new tools, is like the box select as well, little things like that. But yeah, the sphere one's cool. And then I realized that, like, why, like, certain things are gone, like, they've made it easier just to kind of grab your voxels and move them from one place to another, which is kind of cool. So, definitely been doing a lot more vox editing, so it's giving me a chance to see what some of the differences are a little bit more closely. I know there's still stuff I haven't messed with, though, so. But, here's my cactus. So, it's kind of a lot of faces, but it is round and under 5,000 and doesn't move. So, I think it'll be okay. We'll see what the old check says. They might tell me to fuck off on this one. We'll see. But in terms of, like, some of the efficiency, because I could see how maybe they might say, this whole thing could maybe be one piece. Maybe. Yeah. We'll see. Well, thank you, Wicked. But yeah, I need to make another cactus, so that's actually what I'm going to be doing. I think I've saved this palette. Let me check my files real quick. Oh, maybe I did. Okay. So I'm going to do that too, so that's cool. Because I want to make sure that my cactuses match, you know what I mean, for the theme and everything, let alone like from one asset to the next. So I'm going to try to, you know, keep moving the palette along, and we'll see how that goes here. So, but I think I want to check and make, because I think it's essentially the stock one, because it's not like anything crazy, because like I'll go with the flower, for instance, and it's one of the other standard templates that comes with the template, basically, because that's pretty much the colors that we're supposed to stick to anyways with the game maker fun shit. So So I generally don't deviate from that, and if I do, it's like I'll use the base shade and move from there up or down, whatever which way I need to on the hue thingy over there. Yeah. So yeah, I can do some cactus. be fun. But I also don't necessarily want to have to guess which ones I'm turning on and off. That's the only reason why I'm going to export this palette. So that way when I bring it in, it should just be, you know, I know exactly which ones. Okay, this one I did mod, that's right, because the blue, I needed to make like a special one, and some of the, there's a couple other places too. Just because of the emissions, because that's one of the things that, like, your colors in Voxedit are going to look different in the Game Maker. So when I brought it into Game Maker, which we'll do at some point here again, I needed to change it, and so basically, and you'll see over here on my palette, that this emissive color right here started as this one, and then I just dragged it down to where it made the most sense once it was brought into the Game Maker. And so this is the palette that I wanted to make sure that I had. Because the other one, I said, that one's pretty much the same thing. But if you haven't done that before, you just click the little menu dealio thingy here. They hit save palette, and then you just call it something. I'll just call it blue button. The end. Because I might have other colors I might add specifically for the other one. But I definitely wanted to open this up to kind of do that, and then, you know, kind of give a basis of what I'm working on for this stream, anyways. We'll check it out. Actually, maybe I can just do that real quick, anyways. So I want to see, because it. For some reason, Game Maker, like, selectively updates shit. I don't know why. It's kind of frustrating. But, yes, you can just, like, delete that one folder in your Windows files or your file manager there. And it should reset everything in terms of all the images, assets, etc., etc. Game Maker's just loading up in a second here. Switch over that. And I'm kind of getting in the habit of having some biomes to test different shit in. Because, you know, not everything is in the same, like, barren grass thing that you see me test stuff on. So here's what it looks like with the night setting. And yeah, this still hasn't updated. Because see how there's, like, that chunk right there that isn't glowing? That should be glowing. And some of the other stuff hasn't updated either. I don't know why that happens. It's pretty obnoxious. But maybe what I'll do is I'll do that delete cache thing here. Well, that part won't necessarily be on screen, but I'll kind of see if it changes that. And basically, underneath Snoop's left foot there, you can see how there's like a part that isn't glowing that kind of jets out to the left, you know, towards the sword. And so I balance that out so it's supposed to look a little more rounded. And then the darker emissive lines should be a little bit darker too. So we'll see what happens. Now this is a creator fun thing. It just happens to look like a blob thing though. So I can see where you're coming from on that. And you can tell on this one, I turned off the collisions on the flower. So, like, the player doesn't stand on the flower, they're standing on the meat of the cactus there. But yeah, the theme that we're working on, you can kind of say there's like an 80s kind of concept to it. And it's supposed to be like a neon desert. So, like, this is where this neon plants, neon colors come from. But this is what it looks like during, like, desert. And so, yeah, I was testing it different, in the different lights, of course. Because it's kind of tricky to do, like, neon. Like, what does neon mean? And especially not just at night, but, like, how now, during the day. What does that look like? You know, things like that. And so we saw this guy hasn't really updated, which it should. So I'm definitely going to delete that fucking folder this time, because I need to see that. Because I did submit this one already. But yeah, so there we go. I'm going to change this back, though. Tonight. There we go. I don't think I need to save it, though. But anyways. So yeah, I'm making a cactus. Not too unlike these that are here right now, but like how these are flat. Like, yeah, I'm not making my cactuses flat. It's going to be similar to like a San Pedro cactus. So I'll have to put up my reference. There's definitely some game jamming going down though. So, those assets, like, because there's a team on that, so it's kind of, you know, there's a different workflow, and it's all kind of just starting to, I mean, there's a little bit of time left, and, but already quite a bit of assets have been made, so it's been pretty cool. Looking forward to what we end up coming up with, so. But Woke Zombie, you know, is hammering away in his hole there, because it's like comes up and he shows us a little bit of what's going on already, and it's already laid out pretty well, I would say. And then it's just like we're telling him, like, let us know where the assets need to go, what you need, blah blah blah. It's gonna be good. So that's the idea, you know, play to everyone's strengths, make it to where it's relatively easy, you know. Because no matter what, a decent game should be made, you know? And I still, speaking of kind of decent games to be made, I'm going to go back and do the game jam, the GMAE game jam entry. Because, like I said, there was just certain aspects that were just rushed, and they just didn't, yeah, you know, so, and it's published already, so I want to kind of finish it up, and make it enjoyable, kind of like a timestamp, you know what I mean, in terms of the sandbox, because as we know, like, X amount of years from now, I'm sure different people's positions will change, things like that, and so I want to update it to be a little bit more timeless in that regards to, like, when it happened. And then, of course, like, the stuff that we wanted to include that we didn't in terms of some of the gameplay and just other things like that. So, so it should be a fun little journey with at least a little bit of replayability. That's kind of where I want to update it to. And that's something that I might jump into, even, like, kind of just open it up again and kind of refamiliarize and stuff like that here, too, on the stream. Just depends. Like I said, since this weekend, like I said, I don't really necessarily have, you know, like, there's no half-dork, so pretty much I was thinking about, well, I just keep doing. For now, let's create a new asset, though. Create a new asset. This is still a cactus. I'm gonna create another folder. Okay, I'm still called Blue Control. The fuck is this thing called? Yeah. We have to, like, label our assets a certain way. for Game Maker fun stuff. And sometimes, like, we have to cram that into, like, whatever the characters allowed in Voxedit are, which could be difficult sometimes. So, and then a lot of times that doesn't necessarily directly reflect what the asset name is in the marketplace. They just limited the characters. So I always have to kind of contrive some way to abbreviate what I'm doing. So how are you guys doing today? Weekend off to a good start, I hope. And what did you think about the Atari experience, by the way? Okay, now I'm just kind of thinking. let me pull up my reference. Okay, yeah, I agree. I would say that's probably my favorite experience so far. Like, in terms of just, like, yeah, it was kind of fun. And you know, kind of an example of, like, a certain type of game in the sandbox that can be done, which is kind of a blend of you know, this whole metaverse thing, obviously, in terms of being linked to somewhere else, but then adding, like, a kind of, like, a added element to classic game, like the Crystal Castle. Hey, Cold Cuts and Cheese, welcome. Oh, man, I have no idea why that happened. Excuse me. But yeah, we're talking about the Atari experience, and how it was pretty cool. At least Keeper and I thought, anyways. The single player one, you know, the social hub is a social hub, right? I guess it's a pretty cool one. It's not like it's a, like, it was, I think it's, their social hub's pretty neat too. As we know, the concept of the best is a fallacy, so... What the hell is my reference thingy? Oh, goodness. I'm trying to get a picture of what I'm doing on the screen here. Okay, there it is. I couldn't find it in my OBS. Okay, there we are. So, I'm doing a cactus like that, but neon blue. Yes, thanks for joining us there, Cold Cuts and Cheese. We're just kind of getting going anyway, so good timing. Just talking about... this first thing I'm building here, which is a cactus, because I am going to use their spherical tool, the new fangled spherical thing, and I was just kind of getting into plotting the design for this kind of cactus to be done in a neon blue style, because that's the theme that we're supposed to be working on this month. And I just got done showing, like, you know, basically a huge exaggeration of a peyote cactus. So, yeah, you know, and I, you know, our Saturday here just got started. You know, it's only like 3-something a.m. for me. It did rain here, so that was good, because it was hot as fuck. Oh my god, it fucking sucked this past week. This was a nice change of pace. The escape room artist joins us as well. How's it going? We're talking about different things, like the weather and cactuses. So, neon blue cactuses, cacti, cactuses, all that stuff. and other various projects going on. Because why not? Sandbox is fun, really. But, wanted to bring this to everybody's attention. Just went down, and this is one of those things of not like, haha, look what happened, or look what you don't have. Okay, there was an instance of a sword that, you know, rivaled the other great weapons in the metaverse so far, right? And I saw this when it came out, and I'm like, hey, this is probably going to sell out. I want to watch it. And just checking it out a little later, Game Dizzy, you know, posts about this item too, and I'm like, yeah, this is, this thing is probably going to sell out. And I didn't realize how low it has got, how few copies were available. And then PG Live is like, oh, hey, there's only one left. I'm like, oh, fuck, dude, really? And so I had to go get... And I think there was, like, technically two left still when he said that. But now this is sold out. And, hey, Blockchain Barry, thanks for the raid. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm assuming that you're into blockchain gaming and probably Sandbox too, hopefully. So I'm talking about NFTs, you know, as it relates to blockchain anyways, whether one's into, like, Sandbox specifically or not. But this item, which was going for 38 sand, just sold out. There's 44 owners of them. And the cool thing, I didn't even realize it was animated. Oh, cool. I'll have to follow you. Let me follow you back right now while I remember. And so that way I can know. Because, yeah, it's cool. I like to know who to raid sometimes, too. And just, you know, if I see you on other places, suggest you. Yeah, he's doing the... Thanks, Keeper. Yeah, because doing a giveaway. So there is a giveaway going on for this item right now because it sold out. And why it sold out? Because, number one, look at it. It's fucking... exquisite. I mean, that's like a beautiful fucking blade. You know, wow. You know, wow. But then also, 75 fucking damage. That's a perfect roll, as they call it. Oh, you got raided by Sandbox. Oh, so you this is the GMAE crowd. Hey, welcome. Who's ever been fucking doing that all this time, man? You are the hardcore, and we probably know most of you. So, welcome, guys. But yeah, if you didn't catch it, this sword, there's a giveaway. Keeper Top Shot in the chat there. I think that would be the way the chat is over that way on screen. I don't know. Either way. Check it out. Do the retweet thing. Perfect roll. 75 fucking damage. It's awesome. It looks great. I didn't even realize it moved. I just saw its static design, saw the roll, and then I did look and say, oh, who made it? You know, which is, oh my god, where's... Graffetta, okay? And Graffetta has placed in different contests. And so this is part of being, you know, creating a credibility as an artist in the space. You know, and that's one of the things that winning contests does help, because it gets you some notoriety in relation to, like, proficiency or whatever. I don't know, whatever, right? Like I said, the best is a fallacy. So, either way, good work speaks for itself, and this one spoke for itself, because it is great design. Looks really fucking cool. And then the fact that it rolled this, because it could have rolled something as low as, like, a 20-something, you know what I mean? And so if it rolled, like, a 20-something... or like a 30-something, I'm not sure if it would have sold out that fast. Because that's a hard-hitting motherfucker right there. That hits harder than my Blaze stuff, you know? You know how I like my Blaze stuff. So yeah, check out that link in the chat there. I think you should be... the Raiders should be able to see that. Okay, yeah, you should. And yeah, and there's going to be more like this. And like how I know that... let's go back. I think it's on the same... it should be Sandstorm's collection. Because there's some other pretty good roles that they've had. And like this time is a great time to buy shit, usually. This is when everything starts going down in terms of gas. And we of course know our friend and colleague Vvox, also someone who's placed in various contests for different things. But so really, really cool item is these little wings that go by your head. So it's a headpiece, and but it did get a perfect roll. So you got 50 health on that, and that's why it's already there's only 14 available right now. So this is gonna sell out next. So if you want some, you better fucking get them. Like I might grab another one because it's probably gonna sell out. So, but that's cool. Blockchain Barry, your first day streaming, get raided by the Sandbox. Joseph likes to do that, and Conrad, I know he's out sick right now, but he's the other host. They like to do that during alpha season, especially because they know they have a lot of new people coming in and stuff like that, and new streamers. So they do like to raid over into first time streamers, especially. So that's cool. And I'm sure that swarm, it was pretty inviting. You know, usually, that happens, especially if like you're not expecting it. Yeah. Yeah, totally understand that. You know, I remember okay, let's put it this way. Like when I started kind of streaming relatively regularly, like playing shooters and stuff like that, and like I knew that like almost no one was gonna fucking watch me, but it didn't really matter. I was on anyways. I was gonna play anyways, and I know some people like just seeing gameplay. You know what I mean? And so I was doing that, and I got raided from one of the official channels for Splitgate or whatever, and all of a sudden there's like 100 people there, and I'm like, whoa. What the fuck? And I didn't notice it right away either. I was like, oh my god. It was on mute. Yeah. You'd be surprised how much that happens. Like, you know. Even to people who are, like, regular streamers. Like, sometimes, like, you just don't realize you're on mute. And you're just like, blah, 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 blah. And everyone's like, you're on mute. And you're just like, way doing your shit. You know what I mean? That is one thing that the GMAE crowd, if you don't grab their attention right away with something they give a fuck about, yeah, they start poofing. Because a lot of them are just there for the giveaways anyways. So if you happen to have a Sandbox giveaway and you get raided by the GMAE, that's a good time to be like, here's my Sandbox giveaway. And then some people will stick around. But at the same time, it's like, you don't have to worry about them too much, because it's like, you don't really want that crowd anyways who's just in it for the prizes. It's kind of like, but it's cool. I mean, at the same time, some people can just do it, because everyone has time just to sit here and chill and talk about blockchain shit and learn how to build stuff or look at fucking market NFTs and stuff. But, you know, some of us do. But hey, if you raided from now, since then, it's a mighty stream, my friend. You know. You know, respect for that. It's not an easy thing to do. But, that's cool. Hope it was a good time. And streaming while doing the alpha stuff is great because people give you the answers. So if you're ever stuck, just be like, I'm streaming Season 3 Alpha. Need answers, dude. So, hey. PG Live. We got Blockchain Barry here. First time Sandbox streamer rated by the GMAE show. I totally missed that because I was somewhere else. What was I doing? Oh, I think it might have been Cyber Dragon. Because usually I just ride the raid too. But, oh yeah, because then I had an internet issue. It kind of blinked me out. And I think I just didn't connect to that again. Oh yeah, speaking of, if for some reason the stream kicks out, I'll get back on. Don't worry. One way or another. So, Oh, cool. Yeah, I'll keep an eye out. Usually this time, 3 a.m. my time, is when I tend to go on these days. And then on weekends, I'll go a little longer than a couple hours usually. So yeah, keep awesome. Yeah, I'm in the creator fund myself. I've been there for almost 2 years now for the sandbox. And, you know, always doing voxel making mercenary work here. All kinds. So yeah, been at the sandbox thing for a little bit now. But yeah, thanks again for the raid. And I like to say, keeping those sandbox GMAE fires burning, you know? They do recruit, so you never know. And there's a lot more opportunity now just for people who are proficient. I mean, experience helps, but like if you're proficient, you know, you just need certain things built. You know what I mean? And there's getting closer to when we can upload to lands and stuff like that. And that's going to be a huge milestone. And so there's a lot of independent, you know, people, really, because they're not even companies, they're just people who have land. They're going to build stuff on it, but they need people to help them because they never fancied themselves to do everything anyways. And there's ways to make it mutually interesting in terms of tokens, you know? Yeah, I happened to get in on the sandbox pretty early, so like I just came in the front door for the creator fund. And they're just like, apply, you can get in. Yeah, just keep at it, you know. And if you're new to it, just keep watching a lot of these streams. Like, I mean, I'm here working in Voxedit and Game Maker. That's pretty much what this stream is about. Because I'm pretty much doing that anyways. So I'll just like flip the switch on and we'll all watch it. And sometimes I go into like specifically here. Let me move my web browser here. So like right now, I'll back out of this. And right now I'm doing this is sandbox style in the sense that there's a specific style being in the creator fund that it needs to adhere to. And so like sometimes I'm doing like sandbox stuff, and this is how you would do sandbox style shit. And then other times I'm just doing like someone else's stuff or my stuff, and so then where it's like this is how you do the crazy fucking angles that twist and turn, and you and stay under 5,000 faces, and then we'll get into Game Maker and I'm like this is how you make that flow across the map, or this is how you actually make this checkpoint, you know. So, so yeah, we get into all kinds of stuff here. Oh, well, let's go. Hopefully you grabbed a bunch of sand and when that happened. Because, yeah, I could see how that was. Yeah. It's just how it goes. I realize my camera control seems to have gotten nudged over. And I don't know why. There's always little things that you gotta tweak while doing streaming. Oh, it's because my view. Okay. my camera always gets knocked over a little bit, so I'm always having to like see where am I flowing off from. So and then of course I keep my VODs, so there are random techniques about different shit in there. So if you can skim through it and be like, oh, I want to learn how to do lightning, there's stuff on how to do lightning there. You'll see, you know, characters, all kinds of shit. More Game Maker as of late, because this is a significant update that just happened. Okay, so we're going to make a new one, and we're just going to call it Pedro Base. cool, yeah. Because, yeah, we do like to talk crypto in general, and that's one of the things that how we know NFTs can secure your value. You know what I mean? Like how during any one of the bear dips, right? If you had land and it was next to a Tari, like I don't care what sand is, I don't care what Ethereum is at, you're gonna have to give me many thousands to cough that up. You know what I mean? And so that's one of the things that these NFTs can do if depending on which ones you got. So. Okay, so how tall is this motherfucker gonna be? I think it's gonna be 96. Let's play with that sphere tool. But I'm gonna go ahead and load up my palette though too. Like I was mentioning, it has to be a certain palette, and this is just the ones that are with the templates. So it's nothing fancy. It's like quite the opposite. Holy fuck, dude! Really? That's a pretty cheap price too. That's cool. I mean, great. That's But yeah, that's even relatively cheap. So that's kind of case in point, right? The NFTs can secure your value in the market. It just kind of depends on which one you got. Oh, cool. So yeah, doggies are great assets, dude. If you got in on the pre-alpha stuff, it's like they already paid itself back for the most part. Yeah, see, exactly. Same thing, but I did too. I didn't dump in as much as I should have. That's an amazing come up though. But yeah, that's that's what happened. I remember there was a gap where like I just kind of didn't think about my land, and then I was like, oh, we'll check that, and it was like already spiked like big time, and I'm like, whoa. So, but I see why. I understand why. Oh, nice. Yeah. This guy, this PG's got an empire here, man. I'm telling you. Well, let me import my shit. I exported that palette already. I'm gonna load in the one I made for the cactus in particular. So that way I'm matching. Yeah, there's a lot of people that came up big. I'm gonna do a regular green for now. And that's really cool. Like I said, I mean, I ventured what I could. Let's put it that way. And it's like, if I had more, would I have? Yeah, but. I didn't, so I couldn't, so whatever. And yeah, I'm glad I did, because especially during that time, I know a lot of us know that it's all height of COVID, and a lot of our mutual interests were all kind of shooken up in different ways, and, but yeah, I do often think to myself, should have bought more fucking land. It's like, should have just did it, but I'm happy, and it's still not out of reach, right? Honestly, it's not that outlandish, especially if you do start working in this space. Oops, what the fuck? Okay, what the hell happened? Oh, it's just not straight, that's why. So let's undo that. July. Yeah, I have to go back. I'm not sure, cause yeah, that's the price that I remember too when I came in. Cause and how I found the sandbox was actually, vicariously through Decentraland. Yeah, sure, go ahead. And that came from a random thought of like NFTs. And like how thinking that someone has to be doing some kind of virtual real estate, and so then I found Decentraland, and I saw, oh damn, these things are worth a crap ton of money, and so I'm like, someone else has to be doing this who isn't quite as far along for cheaper right now. And so that's why I saw the Sandbox. So I'm like, oh yeah, see, here we go. And then I was reading about what is the Sandbox, like what are they trying to do, what's the goal here. And then I saw, like, especially with their marketplace and things like that, it was a very, very practical model and a very reasonable deal, or very generous deal, honestly. It's not even a reasonable deal. It's like that nowhere can artists keep 95% of the fucking proceeds from these kind of things most of the time. So that alone was really cool, let alone the blockchain aspect of potential royalty tied on to aftermarket. That was, like, great, right? So, oh, hey, you're in Australia. So are you blockchain, Barry? I'll get your thingy up here soon in a second. So you are in Australia. Are you familiar with Blaze Games at all? Blaze Games. Buy Blaze shit is like what we like to say. At least I say. Okay. Okay, Blaze, they're Aussie-based organization. Here's a link to their Discord. Highly recommend joining over there on their Discord. They fucking love anyone Aussie and in the Sandbox especially. But me being a stinky American, as they might say sometimes, I'm still one of their homies, and that's why their logo is over there. They're that flame thing. That's the Blaze Games. They also happen to make outstanding NFTs that appreciate in value. So, that's what all brought us together, you know, is our love of tokens. And this Web3 world, you know, of being able to own your stuff, the things that you're buying. And so, here is Big Bad Barry Art Station, big_bad_Barry. Off to a promising start there. Dig the doggies. So, yeah, keep messing with Voxedit. Check out the tutorials that are out there now. Over there, and Blaze has streams regularly too, where they get into Voxedit and Game Maker stuff. And yeah, like I said, they're you know, they, what you could say, I guess they're kind of like the one of Sandbox's official representations in Australia too. And they get real happy if I send Australia in their way. They're like, hey, you did it. I'm like, yeah, I did it. I found one. Oh yeah, see, then you're gonna love their Discord. I mean, they're just entertaining anyway, so everyone loves Blaze Games. You know, their streams. They actually have a contest going on right now, which is actually another good segue. Because yeah, we mutually assist each other in our endeavors here, and they're running a contest right now, where you can win an Alpha Pass, and all you gotta do is check out some of their past streams. And if you see something that's funny, clip it, and then submit it in the Discord. And so if it's selected, you might win some sand, you might win an Alpha Pass with that too. So that should be fun. Because yeah, they're you know, entertaining. And then yeah, definitely try to catch their streams, because they give away great shit. Because they have the ability to mint in the market. And so things like the Lambro, you know, the Lamborghini, that's theirs. All the autos, the really premier ones, not so much the way overpriced ones. Yeah, good stuff. And, yeah. And actually, don't, and I will mention, because I think some of you caught it on my tweet, about the Kingdom of Sakaar and the Goblin Battle Cards. We will be giving those away today. Batman reached out to me. he said, "We're gonna give away a couple of battle cards." Hold on, I gotta find the fucking link, man. He's trying to stall, make it look smooth, but it just didn't happen. Just didn't. Give me a second. Okay, there we are. And where are you? There you are. Wait, that's the wallpaper. I am looking for... So I like to find the actual site to mint. If we can. Okay, here we go. I think I found it. Yay. Although... Because this is going to go live with the public mint tomorrow. Post that link in the chat. And then I'm going to bring up... Bring that up on my web browser. There we go. So. Of course, everyone wants more escape room artists. Because they're fucking fun. It's like amazing. It's like they're just cool little cards. So. And there's going to be utility attached to them. In terms of like the actual sandbox integration. So that, like, they're not saying drops, but, you know, I think they're kind of saying there's going to be drops. So. And yes, you can catch King on Crafter's, you know, show, of course. But the Kingdom of Sakaar is a pretty expansive idea in general. So it's like beyond just these cards, it's like there's a whole universe that King has been working on. And so kingofcryptogames.com here. So, you know, yeah, I'm sure you can get there from that. Like, I just want to make sure that it was the same route. And so here's an example of the different cards. And I don't know which cards. I have no idea. Like, basically, we're going to be doing our giveaway thing. And it'll be like, you got the card, because that's what this race is for, or whatever it is. See, they're already being traded. Because they're fucking fun. They're fun little things. It's cool. So. But it'll be 25 Matic pretty soon here. For the mint. Like I said, though, they're, you know, surprise mechanics, shall we say, in terms of what is in store for holders. But you know, when I first met King, in terms of being checking out one of his streams, like, I always noticed how generous he was with his giveaways. I'm just like, wow, dude, this guy. He really believes in what he's doing, and he does like to make people happy here, and I think that, you know, this being his project, and just starting, you know, I'm sure that he's going to deliver on some really cool stuff. I mean, even just the cards as they are, you know? So, but yeah, that's cool. Yeah, you've already, I mean, because, yeah, there's, you know, there's this, it's a series, as you can see in the picture here, there's, and so you have different types of workers, different types of miners, etc., etc., and so you might get a duplicate if you go to Mint right now, or tomorrow, or whatever. And so, yeah, you could totally trade them because someone else wants that one instead, you know, so it's pretty fun, and there's, like I said, there's supposed to be certain items attached at some point. That wasn't necessarily a promise, but we'll call it a rumor. So, giving away a mystery card a little later today. Hey, Vox Machina, welcome. Just letting everyone know that I got a couple of Goblin battle cards to give away today. So that's going to be one of the fun parts of our giveaway portion when we get to that. And we've also been welcoming our new friend Blockchain Barry, who raided us, who have been keeping the GMAE crowd going all the way to this time. So, doing that work. Putting in that work. Well, like I said, you guys are all welcome to join the race when it happens for the cards. And, you know, get another one. So right now I'm making a cactus. I'm trying to decide on where, like how, like where I'm building it up from, shall we say. That's the wrong one. No, yeah. All good, dude. Like, that's fine. You know, it does take time. don't trip too much. It is something, and especially a lot of the quote unquote Sam fam. We all get that. You know, no one's gonna be like, oh my god, he doesn't even have his alerts going. Oh my. Yeah, no, it's not like that. That's one thing that's been really cool about the sandbox in general. Like, nothing's ever 100% perfect, but, like, at the same time, the community at large is very supportive and inclusive, you know? Which is a lot to say for, you know, a crypto experience, let alone, like, a gaming experience, you know what I mean? Usually they could be quite combative, and that's one of the things that I would say that Sandbox isn't. It's not combative. You know, it might get a little pissy sometimes, but never like bad, you know. I have no idea yet, but this is just the beginning, and then I, you know, optimize as needed. And that's kind of why I want to do this as an experiment too. It's like they gave us the tool, so it's their fault. This is what I'm going to tell my lead. Okay. So yeah, this is all kind of an experiment to me too. I don't have to make it look exactly like the San Pedro cactus. I just have to make it look like an obvious cactus though. And not make it like a million faces. So, yes, that's what I'm looking at doing right now. But I wanted to kind of, like, get my boundaries, you know, kind of like sculpting. Like, some people are additive and some people are subtractive in a sense, and I'm a little bit of both. So you might see me switch techniques where I might be adding stuff on one side, but on the other I'm, like, chipping away like it's marble, you know, shit like that. Hello, Toastu, yeah. Oh, yeah, Discord, you gotta watch the fuck out, dude. Yeah. Yeah, stick. Just watch whoever the moderators are, you know what I mean? Or, like, the ambassadors, like Canley Kristen, Rufu. You know, if Rufu's talking to someone, like, cool, like, they're probably a cool person. Like, that's a real person. So, like, dude, I would do that. I would suggest that if I was gonna first go in there. And then, you know, Twitch here, like, you do run into a lot of chill people in the chat, and then, yeah, we all have Discord, we all have Twitter, and you'll start seeing, because those are, everyone who's chill, dude, like, we're all, like, seeing each other's posts on Twitter, too, and stuff like that, becomes kind of obvious, you know. Yeah, PG Live, you're seeing how I'm already getting rid of a bunch of faces by doing what I'm doing here. Because I don't necessarily want it that round. I want it rounded, but not necessarily round anyways. Plus, it's sandbox shit where there's like, no round shit. You know. And then the next biggest challenge about this cactus is not making it look like a fucking dick. So that's gonna, after I get this general shape, the what does it look like test is going to be a very important thing going forward. which I always say is a very important test as an artist. If it looks like a happy face when it's not supposed to, change that motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? If it looks like a dick, do it different. Unless you're trying to make a dick. So yes, I do these tests for myself too, all the time. Like, does that look like anything? Is there a cute little kitty face in there? Because if it's not supposed to be in there, get out. You know, get the fuck out. there's only so many illegal cactuses as far as I know, and I don't know about like customs because it's a live thing. It might have to be in quarantine, or it might have to be like checked, you know, because I'm in the U.S. even though like I help represent the Aussies over there. Wait, over there. So I'm in the States, so there'll be a whole process, you know. Oh, but yeah. Anyways, cactuses. Okay, right now, it kind of looks like a missile or something. I have my San Pedro here to look at as a reference. Well, with Sandbox's ambiguous fucking statements on it, it's like we don't even know if it's allowed or not, you know? Family friendly Playboy competitions, after all. Right, everyone? I guess they're supposed to announce that, those winners, today, I guess. Someone can use freelance, yes, definitely. I'm not me right now in particular. But yes, there's a lot. And check out Sandstorm. Let me get Sandstorm's dealio. They actually have a market, in a sense. And they have a kind of like a job market there too, and also a lot of good kind of like information about like what to do to get started. And why am I not finding their fucking website? Yeah, and then I mean one of the things too to keep in mind, or if Sandbox is something that is kind of new to you in that sense, getting familiar with the format of the Sandbox structure, because like for instance, like there is a limit on how many faces that you can use, and so like how like on your portfolio page there is some really neat kind of sculptures in that sense, but there's way too many faces to be an asset in the Sandbox, for instance. And so kind of learning the ropes with some of the technical side is really important in terms of even contracting work at this point, because these are the standards that are being developed and out of necessity from the building environment. So and yeah, that's cool for, as art, it's great, you know what I mean, perfect. But like how there's a hard cap on uploading in the software too for market to be used in the Sandbox. So like some of they're too high, it just won't even let you put it in the marketplace. They're just like, fuck off, you know? Okay. Okay. Because this is one of those things where, once again, let me back out, first of all. So let's just go ahead and see what this is face-wise right now. So I'll give you an example, right, how we're talking about faces. See, this right now is 1,423. So this right now gives you an example that, you know, there's only so many things you can do with, like, curves in this fashion, you know? And like how you can see up here where my cursor is moving, there's faces it'll tell you exactly how many faces here. And now with our recent update, it is a green deal. See what I mean? That's what I say. You have to do these checks, dude. It's just like, you know, what does it look like right now? Too ambiguous. Yes. So these are things that you have to do as an artist. But I wanted to get some of these, like, some of these rounded things. So I'm going to chop away at it now. Like I said, if you think about, like, kind of more like marble. And then it'll tell you the nodes, too. The nodes also come into factor at one point, too. You don't want hundreds of nodes, if possible. And apparently you need to stay under the 5,000 faces. Now, rumor has it, they've hard-capped that now on uploads, too, everyone. So that we might not be able to force, like, something into that, like, 16K like it used to be. I haven't tested it yet, but feel free to. I'm not sure if I need to test that right now, but it might be worth testing at some point. So I said, what does it look like? And see, that's the thing with with cactuses too, because they kind of inherently are kind of phallic. You know what I'm saying? What's wrong with them? And so there's a characterization that you're doing here when you do these kind of projects. It's not, you're not trying to be like accurate, so to speak. And like, cause like right now I'm looking for, well, let me go like this. I'm looking for a shape that more accurately represents that characterization. And so I needed to kind of have like a boundary of some kind to now start kind of cutting into symmetry like we might see in a cactus. And even this, let's see, I'm kind of curious myself. Like, you'll see when you do shit like that, it definitely changes the count, because now this is only 619 faces. trying to steal shit? Wicked, of course. That's okay, I don't know. But yeah, so it shows. It's not necessarily like the curves, it's how many and where at and how many divides are. Because now this is, like I said, this is over half reduced in how many voxels it was showing. And I even have these like little wing things going on here. Let me turn on, not that one. Let's go back into this. I'm going to turn on our little voxel view. So as we can see, even our little voxel view, it's not the most efficient design already, even still. But yeah, that's why I wanted to test that out in terms of using the curve tool or the sphere tool to make oblong assets that I can then chop back to be the blocky things that the sandbox wants out of me. Because when you contract, it's their job, not necessarily your art. Just do what they fucking say. That's why I tell people, first getting into it. Dropped your Hot Wheel. That's and see, I was prepared for this kind of conversation doing a cactus, because like I said, cactus inherently have a certain shape to them, you know? A cool rocket ship. See, because they have a certain inherent shape to them. And these are these are artistic characteristics that we discuss in, you know, a professional manner here. Wow, if this is a real story, that's pretty fucking funny, dude. It's one of those that you might expect to see on TV or something. So I was kind of looking at my reference here, even though like my reference technically is on the other side that I'm looking on screen. So it's kind of funny. But I like that because like I'm also looking at what can be done with texturing and what doesn't matter. And once again, in the sandbox style, which means I have to take squares out of this thing on the side somewhere. That's kind of what I'm looking at. I'm looking at my reference. I'm seeing like where can I take a big square out of this and be like cactus. So, I don't want symmetry, so I need to shut off not that one, it's this one. Now this is going to add, this may or may not add that many faces, because depending on how this goes. Oh, I thought that would, like, for a second there, Escape Room Artist, I read that. I was like 40. I was kind of like, dude, what? Like, you're playing with your Hot Wheels at 40? I mean, that's kind of cool and all, but damn, you know? And then that happened. I'm like, this is even funnier. Like, saying it would have been funnier if that would have been like how. Either way, it's still kind of like some sitcom shit, you know, right there. And that doesn't need to be on this one, does. Alright, cool. Thanks for hanging out, Escape Room Artist. Sure, we'll catch you again soon. You know, I'm just saying, like, for myself personally, I have way more fun as an adult, I think, than I did as a kid, so I'm good. I wouldn't want to deal with that ever again. No, I think I messed up. Should have totally done the marble session before Escape from Mars took off. Oh, hey, thanks for the subscription. Oh, I already did it again. forgot to switch the mirroring. Either way, let's look at what the face difference is at this point. See, now it's down to 345. Yeah, definitely. Glad that you stopped by, and thanks for the raid too, of course. And yeah, I'm sure we'll catch each other on stream here. Now that I followed you, so I'll see you when you're on. And yeah, it's kind of surprising, like, how few Australians are, like, on during, like, prime time. So, like, your guys' time, you know what I mean? Like, I guess depending on which side of the continent you're on. But I mean, like, how this sort of evening time, it's, like, pretty sparse, you know what I mean? Because even, like, Blaze and Cyber Dragon, who's also one of our friends and allies here, they're usually on kind of more midday. And so, like, Blaze will be on, like, 2 p.m. or something like that. So I think, like, they're going to be on 2 p.m. tomorrow, for instance. So keep a lookout. And they'll be heads up on the Discord. And then, of course, the Twitter page will give heads up as well. But there's really not that many Aussies on into the evening, which I was kind of, like, surprised. And I think that might be one of the reasons, too, why Blaze Games is... Yeah, yeah, so that's what I'm saying. I'm kind of like, it's like I'm on during those times, and I was one of the people who, like, pretty much, I think I was the person, I don't think anyone else was doing the, like, buy Blaze stuff, because I was seeing their value, you know what I mean, just, like, straight up, and yeah, so it all kind of worked out pretty well. no bullshit. I started watching Outback Truckers on Netflix, just to get an idea of the geography of Australia. Sorry. Some of those truckers, man, fucking long assholes. Amazing. Oh, man. But we're going to back out this right now. I kind of rather get into some Game Maker. So let's go back to... Actually, before I go to Game Maker, though, let's do some fucking marbles. I'm sure PG's like, when's the fucking marbles? I'm like, yeah, you're right. I forgot about the marbles. Give me a second. Turn my reference off. Yeah, I saw that. It's like how there's, like, thousands of kilometers. And, like, they're like, we need to get these generators from one side of the continent all the way to the up north part of the other side of the continent. I guess so. Because I saw that, too. Because they're like, yeah, we hit a roof. And they just grabbed the roof out of there and just threw them off. It's like, fuck, dude. It's crazy. That's like tales of alien planets to us in the States here. We're like, whoa. These creatures you speak of sound very fantastic. Upright, you say. They jump. We don't expect... Like, that just sounds like made up to us. You know? And Rufu, I'm sure you'll run into him. He's another Aussie streamer, and he's one of the mods in the Discord. So he's the one that has to, he's one of the people that has to actually deal with all those bots and scammers. And he has this, like, class, like, what Americans would think of as, like, that's an Australian accent. And so, like, a lot of times I can hear it, like, how he would say it. So he'd say something like, we just raw grooves everywhere. You know what I mean? It would come out of his mouth, like, just straight Aussie accent. And you talk to Blaze guys, not so much. They almost kind of sound, they sound a little more sophisticated, you know, in that sense. But fucking Rufu would hate to hear me say that, you know. but you know, hey, whatever. The Aussies are some thick-skinned motherfuckers, from what I could tell. So yeah, so feel free to vote on any maps while you watch it spin by. Or if you don't remember the name, just let me know and I'll look for it. Or try to remember the name and then look for it. Weekends are always kind of funny. Oh, you messaged Rufu the other day? Alright, if I run into him, I'll let him know that Blockchain Berry guy is a legit Aussie. And there is, like, a legit Aussie, role in the Discord. So say, don't forget to do that. I'm actually on the continent, you know? Well, he's been offline, or he's been a little busy, as far as I could tell. We've been trying to catch each other. I actually happened to, like, you know, he had caught a cold or something, and then, like, he was coming out of it. I had this, like, sinus infection thing, and then now we're just fucking busy. I mean, so, but he streams too, and actually, like, him, like, myself and Maddox probably, respectively. Like, I'm not sure if we'll necessarily be on the same time, but he wants us to, like, come on his stream and just blah, blah, blah with him too sometimes. So, he's invited me on at least once before, so he might hear me, and then he might catch me on the Blaze streams, too. I'm on there, you know, fairly regularly. So, okay, I'm going to start selecting these maps, since only Wicked has voted. Okay, let's do the Gauntlet, and... Do we want to do more? No, it's a little too long. Do it later. This is a factory. That was kind of fun. Let's get this queued up. Let's see who's just lurking, you know? Exclamation point play. I don't know if you've ever done marbles before Blockchain Berry, but all you gotta do is type in exclamation point play in the chat, and then a marble representing you jumps on the screen here, and then we race them for prizes. I mean, yeah, probably if, I mean, because I do the quests, like, pretty much as they come out. And so, like, today I might actually do a little bit on stream, because it's usually one of our other friends and colleagues comes on around, what time is it right now? Yeah, basically like another half an hour. So about 10 p.m., you know, over there, Sydney time, I guess you could say. But not on weekends, so today I'll probably just be doing other shit. And so I kind of want to get into some Game Maker stuff, and then all of a sudden, another hour's gone by, and then it's new experience time in the Sandbox, so I might just jump in then. Yeah, I know all of our WASD keys probably are a little torn up. So, Mr. Keratross graces us. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I mean, and like we've learned from some of the past alpha experiences, that it does pay to kind of just get the experiences done with. Even then, this leaderboard thing is new, but there can be random prizes. So like, you never know what they end up kind of saying later if you finish this thing in a certain time or et cetera, et cetera. Or like how the Rabbids experience right now, they're giving POAPs out if you get in there. I think there's still like half of them left or something like that. There's Keeper. So I'm thinking like, I know there's someone else. There's someone else. We should get in on this. But this is our first marble race for the day, so I don't usually wait as long. So let's get this going. This is Bongo Boogie. Thanks to Wicked YouTube. That's awesome. That's really cool. It was a cool story though, Blockchain Barry. And yeah, let's I'll be sure to relay this story to Joseph at one point directly, and he'll fucking love it. Or at the very least, Conrad, who'll pass it on to Joseph. Either way, that's the kind of stuff they love to hear. And that's cool, because yeah, there is a lot of opportunity here, and it is very early. Like, so even though this is Alpha 3, it's still pre-release, so you're still early to the party here. Nick Skull, our stream fastest time so far. Escape Room Artist, though, pulls out in front. Ooh, here comes those ramps. These things can be treacherous. So I'm gonna stay on. Oh no! Keeper and Blockchain Barry have fallen, given the Escape Room Artist sizable lead. Oh no, there goes Caratross. I made it, my fancy car. Wicked U2 is gonna make it too, so that's good. We got 3 players with some points, but I don't really count. It doesn't really matter. So that's kind of bullshit. But Escape Room Artist for now. Get some coolness going. Get some points. Get some voxel prize ticket. Before we get our next race going. So that was 9 points. So let's go. We're going to the gauntlet next. I got the bullhorns on. That's cool, yeah, because it's definitely a strong project. it is just starting. It's like it's not even out yet, quote unquote, technically. So says all it's great time still. Oops. And for our first time viewer slash chatter slash being rated slash streamer of Sandbox, what we're playing for here too is the voxel prize tickets, as I call them. So they're going to be a little redeemable for Sandbox assets as I'm able to mint on Matic. So given these kind of like coupons essentially, and you'll be able to stack them for like higher valued items, shall I say. Then Grand Prix winners, generally, they're going to win what's called another type of voucher, which is the HODL Arcade Golden Ticket, which is more some other long-term benefits for holding. And then also one of the first drops is going to be a Sandbox item, too. Caratross, why are you not here, Caratross? Keeper Top Shot generally has a good excuse. Like, I know your roof was gonna blow off that one time, but okay, there we go. Okay, everything's fine, he's working. That's less of an excuse, dude. Like, I think most of us are working on shit here, you know? And then we go play, and then we get back to doing what we're doing, you know? Anyone else? Give it another moment here. There's Keeper. Alright, I think we got our 6 that we had last time, so let's go for it. Yes. Down the big funnel. There's a lot of ways that marbles can fall off on this one still, so beginning only matters so much. Yeah, we don't know why those. Well, I mean, okay, Caratross. Like, you know, I know you're very well educated in that sense, and it's Ragnarok, right? So it's like it's a Celtic thing. And so you'd have to be getting into like the Moorish invasion and shit. And yeah, there's no Moors in that shit, you know? Yeah, you know, so it's a shadow racist ban. Shadow ran racist ban shadow. I know, I understand, but it's called Ragnarok. This is a Nordic thing. So yeah, hey, Barry is in the lead. Oh. But yes, the irony is not lost on me either. I get that, you know? Yeah, cause, right, yeah. Ragnarok is kind of like the Nordic like end battle kind of thing. Yeah, it's kind of, it gets into like the old you know, lore, and yeah, Ragnarok was like the final battle kind of thing. Oh, there goes Escape from Mars. Hey, Roxy Miguel, welcome. Just doing some midstream marbles. There goes WikiD2. Blockchain Baron Keeper, top shot, neck and neck here. Keeper's like, play again, keep playing, play harder, faster. Caratross is like, eh, I'm just gonna hang on the back. Oh, looks like Keeper might get a jump on the lead. Look at that. Oh no, I think he fell off. Yep, Keeper fell off. Blockchain Barry gonna do? Oh, I fell off. So pretty much as long as you finish, I think you're good there, Barry. If Caratross can finish, he can get some extra points here. Alright, Blockchain Barry. Be sure to DM me your Ethereum/Polygon wallet, and then I will eventually get to sending that fucking NFT out to you. Oh. I'm currently trying to revamp my system because it gets backed up. Oh, there goes Caratross. Off the fucking map. Oh, that was worth 27 points. that was worth a lot of points, too, because everyone fell off. So, oh, damn. I did notice my season points are 2,000. Over 2,000, because I won another Battle Royale on Blaze's stream. So. Alright, we're off to the factory, too, now. Exclamation point playtime. Last race in the Grand Prix. Let's get our names going again, shall we? Caratros, it's that time again. And cool, Barry, thanks. I got your address there. I like how my Caratros time warning sometimes is Hoddle Hills like alert to play marbles. Yeah, that's awesome. If we choose to make that many, I guess we can, you know. And yeah, if the inspiration strikes you, do it, you know, because it'll make it more, you know, lively. So yeah, it'll be cool, it'll be fun. I can't wait to see what's all concocted here. I just know when Woke Zombie's like, I got an idea, and then disappears, like, that's a good thing, you know. So, I mean, he doesn't like disappear entirely, but you know what I mean, he's just like so and like how he complained, like the assets were always like the big thing that was like the hindrance for him, and so it's like I told him, like, just who cares, dude, like, just let us know what you may need to make, and then we're gonna make it and we'll put it there for you, you know, just so he goes, ugh. So hopefully that works pretty good, cause he has a good track record. What did you win? Okay, let me bring up that tickets URL, and I'll post it in the chat here. Cause a lot of us here are the proverbial, like, choir to which I'm preaching, if they're not preaching to me as the proverbial choir, because we're all like hardcore Sandbox and shit on some level. So. And so I only have to give the welcome opening, this is what it is, speech so many times these days. But it's cool. These happen sometimes. These happen. Let me get that on our web browser that I share here. While we let whoever else wants to join. We got 6 already, that's good. And so the last race, you got one of these guys, which is a voucher for some a voxel item. Once the market goes live, and we're able to mint on Matic, there's going to be a bunch of different items that I'm going to mint, and this will allow you to exchange this for one of them, or you can combine them, kind of like an arcade would, for different prizes and shit. And then the Grand Prix winner. Gets one of these, which is also stackable, but it's going to get you this arcade Sandbox item as one of the airdrops. This is the Grand Prix winner right here, and this is generally our prizes, and we have different ones depending on what day it is. Say we're doing some Kingdomless car stuff too, so if you see either one of those show up, that's legit. You'll see. Hey, Archifu. We have a new friend here, Blockchain Barry, so I was just letting him know what we're playing for with our marbles. So if you want to get in on some marbles, you know what to do. So, we'll play more marbles, but this is just the first round of marbles we did today. So yeah, we got 6. Are you in there, Archflu? Let me check. I didn't even look. Let me see. Archflu is not in marbles yet. You want to get on this last race here, Archflu? Marbles before we get going. We're playing the factory. It's a fun one. Yeah, actually, you want to play? Give it time for lag. Alright, few more seconds. A little tiny bit longer. Tiny bit longer. Alright, we're gonna get going. I'm gonna laugh if we get a play in a second here. Let's see what happens. So we're gonna start. But all good. You don't have to play the marbles, you know. I'm just making you play it. Unless you're Caratrust, then I make you play it. So he knows why. Ooh, Escape from Mars. That's a pretty good lead there. Oh, got stuck though. Oh, nope, made out. Look at that. But there's a lot of ways your marble can fall off on this one, so. Gotta see how it goes. Roxy, Caratros, Barry, me, Wicked. Still pretty close. Three. I don't doubt that. Yeah, you golden ticket holders, by the way, don't be surprised if you start getting some token drops already pretty soon. Just FYI. And they'll be Matic tokens, so you don't have to worry about gas and shit. We're calling you Archiflu. Like, look at the chat. Look at this. Oh, Roxy got nailed by the hammers, and so did Barry. But don't worry, we got another race coming up a little later, Archflu. It'll be fine. Don't worry, you'll be fine. This is weekend. This is a little longer stream than usual. So it's still gonna get back into Game Maker. Then we're probably gonna even check out whatever new experience is going on with the Alpha today. Right now, oh, I just fell off. Escape from Mars has a nice lead. This map is steamingly large. Ooh, got stalled by the quality control robot. Oh, again. Oh, Caratros, Roxy fell off. Escape from Mars, though, takes this race. Okay, we got Wicked and Barry still there. Oh, don't worry, Vox Pocket. Don't worry. We're just getting started. See you later, Barry. Wicked just has to finish. So we're going to be doing another marbles race in not too long. I wanted to do a little bit of Game Maker, then we'll come back in. We'll do another race. And we still haven't done the races for the Goblin Battle Cards yet. So the Goblin Battle Card races haven't happened yet, which is going to come up later. So stick around. Just got to get your wallet over to the winner's wallet over to the King and Crew over there. And Wicked's probably going to be consumed by the fire. Probably gonna be consumed by the fire. Nope, maybe not. Oh, but yeah, probably is. maybe not, maybe not. Oh my God, this is, whoa. You made it. You did make it. You made it. But yeah, I think that might have been enough to pull it out for Escape from Mars. Let's see. Number three is Wicked U2. Number two, Blockchain Barry. And his number one is Escape Room Artist. Getting the golden ticket too. So that's cool. That's fun. Yeah, we'll be doing more marbles. Don't worry. It's gonna happen. Okay. Let's go and bring up some Game Maker now, though. Just letting that load up. All right. Game Maker going now. It's nice little elevator music. Keeper's like, let's go back. Okay, that's a, say it has a 3 rating. Holy shit, that's not too bad. Like, usually the Draft Gallery is a brutal place. Doesn't matter how good your shit is most of the time. So, there's a lot of things that are just completely unfinished. And some stuff that could be refined. And, like our end scene, for sure. Got a lot of our friends from the space here. It's like how we're talking about, you know, the crowd, the quote-unquote, in terms of a lot of the characters in the sandbox who've been here for a little bit. It's like a lot of them are right here, including, you know, even non-streamers, but just, you know, people. Yeah. Makers in the space. That's fun. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. So, this is our little quest that we set up to kind of familiarize everyone with the sandbox. I haven't been through it in a little while, so I want to see what happens. Let's go through this thing. This is a short adventure about the sandbox, the stream team, and the online community that makes Sandbox a fun place. Okay, so there is something that Joseph definitely marked us off on. Okay, welcome to this GMAE Game Jam entry. Joseph and I are two of the first streamers for content in the sandbox. Wow! Yes, it has been amazing seeing how much community and the sandbox has grown in such a short time. Definitely the sandbox isn't even fully launched yet. As I said earlier, this game we're going to have fun using some of the essential Game Maker functions creations from the sandbox community. Cool! Get ready. There are 4 wolves up ahead and you're on your way to meeting our friend and colleague Panda Pops. Check your inventory for weapons and armor you may have in your inventory. You can use them. Use your combat base NFTs in this experience. Glad I picked up some gear from the marketplace. Yeah, it's decent enough weed. Yeah, it's, you know, it's from, you know, homegrown produce. Because it's awesome. In California, we can do that. I'm going to use my new sword. And then I think I'm gonna, even though the back is kind of off kilter, I'll still use the Nobody shirt. And then I think it's only appropriate that I use the Wizzy helmet, so hat. All right. So here's one of our wolves, and he's not even getting hit for some reason. So that's something that's not normal. And I haven't checked it. I haven't given a really good check since after, with the 7, you know, update here. But that's funny. I don't know why this guy isn't dying. See, this is why I wanted to play through it again. And here's a debug block that I totally forgot to get rid of, because now they can't get me. And it was made so I can just zip through this without having to do anything, without having to zigzag through this. Okay, well, our predators are not working. Is it still completely legal in Australia? That sucks. That's some backward shit. Yeah, I don't know why those wolves didn't work. And there's a way that you can bypass the trigger for the next thing here. So I need to fix that to where I corral the player in some way to make sure that that's tripped. But, and then I think there is a way that you can get, like, caught somewhere over there on the other one. I definitely put up walls so you can't do shit here. You know, I didn't want anyone, have anyone get caught there. And I did everything on automatic trigger because, you know, it's like, not everyone knows to interact with the person that you're talking to. So I'm just like, oh, they only have medical, huh? That sucks, dude. I mean, California, where I'm at, it's the magical wonderland of fucking weed. So, it's great. Like, I have to keep smoking this because it's like you make so much and then you don't want to just sit too long, you know? And that's kind of where I'm getting to. And then, like, all of our neighbors get to that point too, you know? I mean, that's how it was in the States too, you know? But then it changed because everyone's like, this is stupid. Let's change it. Let's make more money off it. And, like, the politicians were like, make more money, you say. All right, hey, I'm Panda Pops. Yeah, this is for you, Blockchain Bear. I do the official Sandbox Voxedit streams on Mondays, but I guess that would be more like, wait, would it be Monday for you? It would be kind of like Tuesday super early for you. So, that's Panda Pops. All right, Julia Zaman. Friend and colleague Julia would love your help with something. I'll open the gate and see how cool Sandbox powers like that. It's pretty sweet. Okay. That's Banhammer. It's probably going to be minted from Maddox. So we're going to get rid of Barbarian Futters. Oh my god. Why is he not working? Okay. Oh, there you go. Gonna kill one of these fuckers with this thing, damn it. 75 damage. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Pay to win. Pay to fucking win. Pay to win, motherfucker. Yeah. Just buy shit. Pay to fucking win. Alright. So we paid our way to win already there. This stream was on pause. That's pretty funny. And so, like, my respawners, I don't know if I put them in, honestly. I honestly don't remember if I put them in. So, we're going to make these spawn more shit. And then, you know, kind of like we saw with the Smash TV-inspired thing that I'm working on for Crafter. So now we're going to try to find Andy. And here's our Healer Wizzy. Hey, Healer Wizzy. Thank you, Healer Wizzy. Here comes Andy and Touche. So, this is Touche, and this is Andy. We are the creators of Fungi. That's Fungi Kingdom. That's how he talks. Your studio does amazing work. Your experience was featured in Alpha 2, right? Sure fucking was. Yes, thank you. Touche and I are on a bit of a quest too. Can you help us? No. Okay, we're collecting mushrooms. Surprise, huh? They're part of a boop goop in a way. Boop goop. Follow us on social media and catch our streams to find out more. You can also get some boop gooped assets in the marketplace. But for now, let's gather some mushrooms. We'll do. So there was, like, not enough time, and there should have been more mushrooms. But it's like this was, like, almost a complete waste of fucking space. Because we didn't get a chance to put enough mushrooms. Not even get a chance to put out enough glowing vines. You know, these, like I said, glowing shit is, like, one of my, like, kind of things I'll put in to kind of help you know which way you're going. It's good to do that subconsciously. Anyways, if it's not overtly said. now I have the Outer Studios ladders, so maybe I'll change that. It's not nice. Yeah, I had to get one. This thing's a mighty whacker, you know? 75 damage on that thing. Oh my god, I missed it. Gathering mushrooms. Oh, you got one too? Nice. Oh, that's right, yeah, because I saw you said there's only one left, and I'm like, fuck! So yeah, I had to go do it. When I went there, it said that there was two left. But now I know for sure it's gone. We were kind of just looking at that a little bit, not that long ago, on the market. Thanks for the help. Metaverse mushrooms are the best. Continues boop boop gaze. And I was going to have Andy say something else here, but I forgot to copy and paste it. So then you have, like, how are you today? I feel good for no fucking reason. So I'm going to get rid of that. So we'll see how that goes. Just some of these little tweaks. Woo! All right, so I'm down. And then there's some funnies on this one, too. And I don't know if, and see, this is the fucked up thing about Game Maker 6.4 or whatever, was it had you guessing, like, did I fuck that up? Or did it fuck it up? Yeah. So, like, some of these, like our teammate Go West avatar here shouldn't take damage, but did, and I'm like, I thought I did that, you know, and, like, there's certain things, like the gizmo shouldn't be attacking me, but I think the tag went back, or I don't even know why that happened. Like, you know what I mean? So I'm going to go make sure that doesn't happen anymore. Hey, Karaskro 333. We have Karaskro 333 and Karatross now. That's fun. We just need a top shot keeper now. All right. Playing through GMAE game jam entry that we did, my team and I. And I want to go back and fix it. And so I'm playing through it right now. So, right now we're talking to Cody and Lozen. Shoot times quick. Hey, I'm Cody, and this is Lozen. We're the founders of Tempest Studio. We make award-winning movies, games, and even recently released a new comic with our monochrome universe. We have an idea for a shot using our gizmos. That's pretty damn cool! Okay. Why did that not auto-progress? That was weird. Okay. Alright, well, that's why I'm here. And so now, we should get in a fight here. Damn, that is a lot easier with this thing. Yeah, these gizmos, I made them attack gizmos. Ready to do some speed runs. That's cool. Probably check out some of the alpha a little bit, too. And see, they're supposed to keep spawning. Like, the enemies are supposed to keep spawning. And like I said, I don't think my respawner was there. So I just have to wait here. Is it, can I sit still? Yep, alright, so I'm sitting now. And I have no idea why it does that, like, bag folding sound effect when they sit. Fuck's that bag folding effect? Oh, thank you, yeah. I was fortunate enough to be invited onto one of the GMAE streams, and they hooked it up with a hat. So that was kind of cool. The other shit I bought, and then the nobody jersey. So I think it's because I got the week one recap NFT, which is kind of cool. Unfortunately, the new update kind of fucked up backs, but I'm sure they're gonna fix that because that's just, like, weird. Yes and no. The hat was, like I said, it was kind of like a thank you for participating, for being on the show. And I'm just like, shit, I would have paid you guys an NFT to be on the show. I mean, this is... But, yeah, that was cool. We had a chance to chat with Conrad about our experience in the sandbox and what we're doing. And then later he told us, oh, yeah, I got Alex to okay some hats for you guys for participating. And I'm like, fuck yeah, dude. So, yeah, it is there in the archives. Myself and Maddox of Furia were on the same show. And then the jersey is made by Razul, a.k.a. Nobody, or the Nobody, OG Nobody, rapper, game maker. So, all right, let's go do this. There's another funny debug thing I forgot. See that weird-looking mushroom over there that's glowing? That's the same mushroom that I was supposed to get over there. This was just debugged. And I left it there, so I have to go crazy and go fight over there. And I forgot to take that out. And then I noticed a lot of players just did never notice that. Because it would satisfy the quest. So, and there's Karatross right there. Speaking of Karatross, there he is. Making a cameo. So yeah. They need help. The mushroom over there came from ancient meteor. That's what Karatross said. He'd love to study it, but you know, damn Cthulhu gets in the fucking way of science sometimes. And is blocking it. So... I want to know if you want to do the dirty work for him. And I'm like, sure, that's what I'm here to do, is whack things with the fucking sword. And so there's Cthulhu. He's looking mighty, mighty feisty. And so I can just run over here and grab that, and that would satisfy the quest. But you can also jump around him and just do this, too. And he's kind of has a hard time attacking on the surface. But I can fuck him up with the sword, though. That's pretty sure. And so then that satisfied that. Yeah, that was, Maddox made the mushroom there. That Cthulhu is my Cthulhu for the Creator Fund, actually. So that's why it looks kind of plain. So say pay to win. So now I gotta go find Lucas. Luke's gonna be up over here where these glowing vines are telling me to go. Whoa, see? Look at that glowing shit in his eyes. I like this trigger, because like how he's kind of like above you, you know? Greetings, I stream with Alex Weekly and have some news for you. There's a sandbox community party happening at the top of the tree here. All you gotta do is get there. Just head through the tunnel. Sounds easy enough. It is, with all this shit on. Fucking... uncatalyzed 50 health peasant. Look at that. Oh, God. Yeah. You do nothing. Give me no uncatalyzed enemies. Who's this guy next? Just finished dinner. Cool. I'm just beating up on NPCs. And of course, we got the Outer Studios tunnel system going. And I use the brace as the trigger right here. This is the little mini maze Maddox came up with. How to make it so you can't jump back this way. Pretty interesting little concept in terms of like this. It's like kind of like a maze, but not overtly too difficult. And the only thing I changed, I had to make some more room because of the camera in there. But this is kind of like where I added like the two different colored blocks. So at least you had a distinguishing left or right. Like how if you went down this way, you kind of loop back. And so this is like where I came from that spot. So it's like I said, a little mini maze, which was an interesting enough idea. And I think it did kind of help keep this little transit up to the top of the level a little more interesting. Oh shit, I fell. Okay. Alright, but then when you go down this side, this will take us to our next stage. Which is a little bit of a jump puzzle, but meant specifically not to be like too hard once again, and not too punishing. Like how you saw, I could fall, and nothing happens. I think I could fall all the way back down on this one, just because it'll lead me back to a loop. But man, here's more of those tunnel braces, which look fucking cool when you run down them. Oh, here comes Joseph and Conrad. Gets a bit tougher from here. Like our chat often suggests, just get good, you'll be fine. That's a fantastic idea. In the nicest way possible, of course. I feel motivated, like no one day defines me. Thanks, Vision X and Conrad Condad. Alright, so let's go do the murder, as they say. Slicing them up. All this pay-to-win stuff. I have so much health. Okay, let's see how... Wait. The charge attack I know sometimes can be a little funny. Damn, that took off 127. But yeah, this version is in the draft gallery right now still. It's been a while since I played through it, so I wanted to check it out again and remind myself what I wanted to change. I did want to make this a little bit more interesting, though. This part in particular was kind of like sort of abandoned. But it's just ran out of time. So, hey, they did move. I was like, didn't those move? Yeah, because the idea was to make a like a parkour scenario, but not so, like I said, unforgiving to where you're gonna die. But also kind of motivate you not to fall, because those there's still probably enemies at the bottom, if you saw. And that was one of the things I was gonna put in there, is to make sure that there was a certain amount of enemies that would respawn if you did fall. Then the other thing too, just didn't get to do, was lay out some of these weapons, and some of them are gone. Huh, that's weird. I'm Half-Dork, Game Jam winner and Sandbox streamer. And this, yeah, of course, Half-Dork plays Dungeon Master for a lot of the team there. And so yeah, here we go. But I wanted to get, and see, these weren't collectible for some reason. So there, okay, there it goes now, finally. But I wanted to put these items out for the player to try, and then of course we have the healing. Going into the last part here, and then I wanted our Blaze Games, our Blaze ally here, this is Blaze Games' avatar they gave me to use. I wanted him to spit out the different Blaze swords as like a help. It's like that, he just spit out the one, Blaze Saber, but, I want over time to keep just dropping more and more weapons on more of the Blaze Saber stuff. Yeah, killing all these guys ain't shit with all this stuff. These are all uncatalyzed, you know, base players, the barbarians. So now I pretty much just gotta sit here because, like I said, my respawners weren't necessarily working. So just gotta sit and wait for the time now. Like for us, you know, no excuses, of course, is just like, you know, circumstances, just time became more of a factor than I think any of our team anticipated. And so yeah, the you know, I say, like, these refinements that we're talking about here just kind of weren't able to get to them in time. All right. We've almost survived. We've almost survived the test. Oh, look at that! Look at that monstrosity! Look at that. We got Young NTO. We got Sandbox. Got Blaze on the shoulder. You know. And we got Snoop, Wizzy, just chilling. Transparent block. All right, there we go. Okay, now we're gonna join the chat. Okay, all right, did trigger. Everyone's boogieing. And then I come here and now we're done. Wow, that took me 22 fucking minutes? Fuck. Wow. Okay. 42 kills. All right, good to know. Everyone did die in this motherfucker, so that's good. So there's cold cuts of cheese. We got Max right in front. There's Keratos off to the left, you know? I remember frantically setting these, like, you know, these up, you know, going, fuck, you know? Oh, Kai brings pain. But here's what it looks like behind the scenes. There's a lot of, invisible walls. So. Whoa. So yeah, want to make sure that things can't go too off the rails, which is going to remain the same. It's just that the guy actually kind of polish up some of those rails, because like I said, some of them didn't go quite as planned. Alright. So this is probably, I'm not necessarily going to jump right into this right now. I kind of wanted to just play through it, you know, on stream, and whoever's here get a chance to see where we're starting off from, because I'll probably do some of the revamps, or at least some of the overall restructuring offline, and then we'll come back and see the difference kind of thing, more than I want, like, I'll get too much into the tutorials, like, right fucking now. What the hell happened there? Okay. Oh, it's just I'm just kind of selecting it. That's why. Like, why is that one turning a weird color? But as you can see, this is sort of the behind-the-scenes look. How to make that on-the-rail game maker experience. Cool. Let me switch back up over here for a second, and then let me get out of the game maker at the same time. And then we're gonna open up some more models. Because we got some fucking giveaways. Wait, is Pickaxe Smashers on right now? Really? What? Oh my god, they are.
Hold on. Just take a look at the marketplace and see what's available. Now, there's other type of stuff that you can do also. You can create NPC, which is a non-playable character. That one could be either an ally to help you on your adventure, or it could be an enemy. With those type of NPCs, if it's an enemy, okay, you can later on put some catalysts and chance to give that enemy
some
or
of these
ally
things here.
Power-ups. And with those, you create more difficulty in your game for the player to complete it, or you can create different dynamics. Other type of things that you can do on Voxedit is equipment. You can do different equipments because you have 6 different slots to equip stuff, from the weapon, the shield, the headwear, the chest wear, or chest plate, let's call it something like that, the arms, the legs. And I believe that's after all 6.
Yep.
Now, the pickaxe will fall. Yeah, go ahead. Sorry. I'll continue later.
Alright. So this is Pickaxe Masters. And the votes are open for maps to play on marbles. Maybe we could play some marbles, multi-stream our buddy Pickaxe Masters here at the same time. Just letting them know I'm streaming them too while I'm streaming. Alright, we got Onto Nice and we got Alienated.
I was about to first of all say hello, OJ Shakespeare. How are you doing today, man? I saw that you're also streaming, and you're streaming. We are streaming on your stream right now. Have you already finished what you were streaming? And tell us. And if, by the way, first of all, if you aren't following OJ Shakespeare right now yet, please do it so right now. OJ Shakespeare right is now. A very talented creator. Usually, he does a lot of work with Maddox of Furia as well. I don't know. You have to know him and follow him as well. And let me open real fast OG Shakespeare here. Link.
He's gonna so that we now can we're going to do your stream section thing.
So if you're not doing it right now, please go put a follow on OG Shakespeare and watch his streams. He's a very talented creator. He does a lot of tutorials as well. And he wants you to get better and get good.
Gotta get good.
So back at it. I was just to finish before we went on how to install the Voxedit. So there's different types of assets that you can do, you will be able to export to the marketplace later. And one of those we were talking about equipment. It's weapons.
Because we all like the different material.
And in terms of what we're going to use.
We want to hear more about it, and it's good to stay in touch.
As a weapon that's going to be used or that's going to be held in the right hand.
This is my marbles position for it. It's going to be smaller.
The templates that we want to use, it's the equip plates.
Hey, how the hell? We're multi-streaming. Pickaxe Masters, just getting a new game of marbles going.
Anything that goes
and this marbles game
and will be treated
is
as
for
a it doesn't
one of the
need to be a
goblin
blade.
Battle cards.
Pickaxe actually can design anything you want and give that
Grand Prix winner
weapon behavior. Let's call it like so, because the avatar will be moving the hand like it's attacking with it. So you want to make something, you want to design something that will also go along with that animation. We are not sure if we're going to have some custom attack animations that will be exportable to the avatars, but if so, we want to also have some mining action type. So instead of having the slash that's currently the
Caratross is really great this time.
Templates for attacks, we hope that in the future we'll be able to export our own, or import, I don't know, probably export. Yeah. Our own animations in terms of the attack, because we want to see the mining movements into the attack. So let's open up that blades.
Yeah, so to do it probably the best way, so you should probably, when you press on the template, don't press save immediately, but probably create a folder, and I would just name it PPA
We got 8. Anyone else want to join? Yeah, give it a little more time since the stakes went up.
Yeah.
Since we got a goblin battle card to give out to.
And in this folder, now I will name, like, this is the first one. And it will create a folder and only then place all of those files in there. So now if I press save, it will create a folder by naming it 1. So yeah, that's probably the safest way to do, not to lose data and just to keep track of it as I found it.
Although I would put like an abbreviation rather than just like 1, because then you have like a bunch of 0-1s and it's all like a bunch, you know, different assets. So you might want to put an abbreviation, like it's like pickaxe PA 0-1 or pickaxe, you know, brown, you know, something, I mean. So you don't have like 100 0-1s.
I wouldn't say lost because they're there, but very hard to track on. Okay, so this is what we find when we open up the templates.
Yeah, so this is what we find.
Let me know how the volumes are too.
So if you want, you can always.
Well, we might be getting this race going here because I think we got everyone. We got 8 right now.
Convenient theme for you. Like, I would buy this one just for.
Yeah, I saw Alex do that. I really like that one as well. The purple.
Okay, there we go.
I don't know. I just.
All right. Actually, let's get this first race started, shall we?
I heard that sometimes if you have some kind of visual bugs, you just go there and change and resets the UI, so it can get you like out of sticky situations. Now the controls to rotate is a bit tricky.
Oh, keeper just shot right down. Keeper's like my card. My card.
A little bit. Yeah. So if I the Alt button does not do anything like in Game Maker.
Ooh, Hollow Hill though. A good boost there. Uh oh, takes the lead. Hollow Hill has a nice lead now on this first map. Little stall, a little bit of stall. Karatrust making up some of the way.
But
I'm in the way now, speaking of. Look at you two though, made a move. And now I'm in first. This is bullshit. Damn my fancy car. So far we haven't lost any marbles, so
right mouse button.
Now one's still in it somehow.
The rotate, like, zoom out.
Oh, there goes the floor.
If I press it,
we could made it through like the top like route, but got a little stalled. Escaper Martins is pulling ahead now. Ooh, followed by Karatros. Everyone else is stalled. Ooh, Karatros getting whipped around the ice vortex. It still comes out. Quick. Look at that.
So yeah.
Ooh, Escape from Artists.
Like any program, it does take its learning curve.
Yeah, a little bit, but all software have this. It just needed to probably to know what.
Looks like Karatros might be taking this race.
Before you continue on the explanation, Gibbosh, I just want to give the chat some time. While we finish it. So, what's going to be our suggestion? Please write down
in the chat
what type of pickaxe we should build together. Is it going to be a wooden handle? Is it going to be an old handle? What type of handle? Is it going to have a termination? And the pickaxe, what's going to be the theme of the pickaxe? What materials are we going to use on the pickaxe? Give us some idea in the comments, throw your wild ideas, and we'll build something together here. Now,
do we have any ideas for a pickaxe?
From everyone that's watching the stream.
Type that in if you're not already in there, too.
You're saying some really cool stuff about
Escape
it.
Escape from Mars gets second, so that's still some points.
Voxedit, and they might want to learn something about
There's still
it.
Two more races, Barry, don't worry.
Okay. So, probably the next thing that we have to get into it is this tree node. It's simply just
I'm going to post Pickaxe Masters channel in the chat here. So Blockchain Barry, this is another channel to follow. This is who we're watching right now in the corner there as well. And they're talking about Voxedit and how to make some weapon templates. So So yeah, Escape from Mars, Wicked U2, PG Live, Vox Machina, Keeper Top Shot, Hollow Hill, and then we'll see if I beat the fire or not.
And that's all the components from that part, right?
Like if you can see, it has two files attached to it.
So I'm slowly making my way down.
If I just press on
slowly
drag,
going feature, down.
Select this
and there we go.
I cannot.
So, that was like 25 points. Escape from Mars was 16.
I'll be just making the
demo. And we're going on to our second map, which is Alienated.
Sorry, I just can't seem to select the file.
And remember, if you happen to get abducted, that's a special prize.
Isn't that the pieces that are on the right side? No.
Well, they click
hey, we've got Blockchain Barry, welcome. Welcome to the stream. We are the Pickaxe Master. Usually we do the Lucky Miner show on Wednesday, but today we're doing a special stream that's dedicated to Voxedit. And we'll be going with some pickaxes with you today, you that's watching the stream. And right now we're just trying to get on the first basics of the Voxedit. It seems that you're still figuring out some
basics
things.
Basics are important.
We usually don't work. We are more into the game maker. So this is a
well, they say
different
that,
type of stream for us.
Misty yeah. Mountain looks immaculate. I know they have builders for it too, but still.
I cannot move any position of this. So this is intended. We should not probably unlock it. There is a way, and you can probably search it on the Google, but for us, we don't need it. Basically, what I wanted to say that if this file would be unlocked, if I move this handle...
Caratross,
like,
I don't understand why I don't see her name on here.
A file, not file, but...
I know. Yeah. Well, he's got to get better at multi-streaming Hollow Hill, you know what I mean? If he wants to hang with the hardcore... Gotta know how to balance your sound, you know? Let me know, because if you guys are all using your sound instead of mine, like, I could turn mine down, so we're just all somewhat synced, you know what I mean? We got this down to science, you know? Last alpha trained us well, you know?
Yeah, and the only way that we will edit this blade is just going... We have this handle, we have this file right here, and we will press this little, like, paint button right here. And it will open up some kind of a little different editor.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's different. When you're on your phone, yeah, you can't really do the same thing. But yeah, when we're on our PCs and laptops. Or if you're Batman, he's monitoring in his sleep right now somehow. We got six this time. Who are we missing? Wait. I'm not seeing Escape Room Artist. Oh yeah, I should hope so, Hollow Hill, honestly. I know you heard the call of the marbles echo through the metaverse and into the real reality. And you're like, it's time for marbles again. I must rise and win.
Here we go.
Okay, there we go. Yeah, PG Live, finally. It's okay, buddy. We're all just waiting on you.
I only use
we lost Barry. Barry's gonna miss it again.
And the color. So it's, I don't know, me easy. Now about other.
But, like I said, this is for a goblin battle card. So, options. Like I said, I don't mind waiting. And there's no half dork. So. This is like a different kind of hype session. This is a chill session. Yeah. Hey, there he is.
If I use line,
you have 10 of them? Nice. So wouldn't it be nice to say you have 11, which is past the mint? You know what I mean? You're like, I got one more than the pre-mint. But you never have too many of those things. They're cool.
In the shortest way, those boxes.
I said, I do think that there's going to be some neat voxel items attached to it, too. Oh, really, Huddle? Really? What? You have none? Wow. That just does, that just seems weird. I didn't have a bunch of liquidity to necessarily throw at it, but I made sure, I wanted to make sure that at least had a couple. So I got a couple of them. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool.
Let's create the volume option.
Yeah, so this is some sort of spare. Well, this tool is probably which everyone uses the most. It's,
oh, cool. So you can do 20 now. Nice. Oh, hey, there's escape room artist. You know, King and Batman are very adamant in the sense that they want to get, like, you guys here, they would like to get them in your hands, because they know all of you are the ones that are out here on Twitch all the time, and, you know, sort of grinding in the trenches here, you know? It's cool that they're going from doing like the beginner beginner setup and such. So, oh wow, you want a legendary? That's fucking badass. No, keeper. No, no. Alright, we got 9 this time. I think we're gonna get the second one going. Look at. Alienated.
Yeah, then we have a very
watch out for aliens. We'll abduct
you. Select color because as you can see, we have a large palette of colors right behind the corner right here. There is quite difficulty to probably remember all of them in the beginning. So I use like E.
Caratross has Lee. Oh, he's got a boost from the UFO. Which is kind of fitting. Oh, there's Escape from Mars too. Got a nice boost from that little sighting.
Oh, now it's it's different. If you can, if you drag.
That's the palette tool.
Oh, yeah, Barry and Vox Machina just got their momentum stopped by those pylons. So far, no one's been abducted.
Oh, that's a good one.
On, just go on the
Caratross with the lead. Still the lead. Escape from Mars not too far behind. Wicked. PG Live. Followed by Blockchain, Barry, Fox. Oh, Fox just pulled ahead. Oh, Barry got stuck on the corn. Yeah, that's how. That's usual. Yeah. Givish is usually a little bit lower. It was an interesting race here still. Here comes our UFO. Don't forget the basket moves.
And
so
we got already some suggestions here. And also, welcome Rosario and welcome you the fist. Mm-hmm. How you guys doing today? Hope you're doing well and hope you're feeling great. So we got some suggestions here by Yannick Marine. Steel handle with diamond head. We
Caratross,
already have
the is he gonna
I'm
make
sure
it in? Is he going to make it? Oh, he is. Caratross.
We have wow. The last Pikachu suggested by Donnie N.
Wow, Caratross. There you go. Two of them in a row.
Says a Pikachu that looks like multicolored play dough. We can do.
We can
I
do
think
2 second. PG Live third.
Or the Pikachu. That looks
Escape
like
Mars just fell
play.
Off. Keep.
And
oh, wait.
Yannick,
I got abducted.
Other suggestions? Just
I'm getting abducted.
Diamond, we already have one diamond pickaxe.
There I go.
It does not feel good to make another one right now.
This is a good Marvel's day for
just
you. Here comes Blockchain Barry. Hopefully, we'll make it before the fire.
A game creator is doing its own game, which is the farmer community. He's doing it all by
UFO.
Himself. Does take a lot of hard work to do it, so if you haven't yet following this project, please do so. Give him some support. Here comes
love. Barry. He's you gonna make it
from scratch, ground zero.
Oh, like a sick joke. It just moves away.
See, there's a pickaxe possibly in this game.
That's hilarious.
So check it out. There might be some cool stuff coming.
Those are 22 points. Wiki's got 15. Let's see what
no,
looks like so far.
At least we couldn't not.
So escape room artists and Wiki you
now.
Two aren't completely out of
wanted
it.
Wanted to make some.
We don't know how many points our next round's gonna be worth. You never know. Someone could be as enemy at the gates, so a lot can die.
Invisible blocks.
Which could just jump right over Caratros. So you never know. You never know. That's why these maps are fun. The ones where the marbles can fall off.
So what should we go? We have the glass pickaxe, which is quite interesting, I have to say. A glass pickaxe. It doesn't seem very useful.
Doesn't seem
more
useful.
Like a decoration. If you think of smashing something with a glass, you're going to break the pickaxe at your first hit.
Then if it's like special
like
magic dwarf
clay.
Glass, you know, I don't know, I'm just saying.
It would be like a rainbow pickaxe. It could be. That would go something on, along the lines of People of Crypto. Oh, Gush is saying, wait, you can make transparent blocks unless the option is disabled for the time being. So there are transparent blocks. But I do remember we had the idea of making some ghosts and we needed some transparent blocks. Well, there was something that needed transparent blocks. But well, since last time we've discussed this, it's probably been over 6 months now, so a lot of things have already changed. Maybe now we have transparent blocks. And we could use those for the glass pickaxe, probably.
Transparent blocks is in like blocks but for the land, blocks, but not for voxels. Not voxels. You can make it to where not all of your voxel asset has anything in it. So like how like I showed the spaceship that I've used before, how the windows you
probably
couldn't go through them because it had collisions,
yeah,
but there was no voxels there.
And what about glowing blocks?
I've got 7.
Only blocks? Yeah, give us his right. Okay, so we cannot make transparent voxels, only transparent blocks.
Yes.
Well,
who we got? Yeah, okay,
like
Caratros did this time. Can't give him crap. I'm surprised PG Live isn't in here, considering the love of marbles yet, you know?
That is just to get the reference?
Like the gargoyle.
On the invisible side, just to.
Why not just not do glass right now and just do something that's easier? I was saying, you know, if I was there in the room with them. There's PG Lab.
Well, it should be edible.
Don't make me do
right
it right now.
Now you can see the place where you can put the voxels, right? probably
I
it's
think that
possible.
We have to unlock it.
And create a new node.
Yeah, you have to be able to move the nodes.
Yeah.
Some and if the extra, just a tip. Like a lot of times, it's best just to get just use the extra node that they give you. And get rid of the rest of them because then you can create more children off of that, and you can move those with the mover and select thing. If you want
to
stay within there.
So I also thought that here we can add like a lot of volume, so no problem. Just collision boxes are then bigger.
But we need to change that editing area.
Anyone else in on this last race? We got 8 in right now.
Sort of
give another moment before you hit start.
So
while we watch the
right
pickaxe masters forge a
if
pickaxe eventually.
File, yeah,
let's do it.
Okay.
Let's do it.
So okay. So everyone, you now have to go. Probably the easiest way we can do this is probably from the file you have.
Oh, and by the way, we got Yula's gameplay NFT over YouTube. Good morning. How are you doing today? Hope you enjoyed the show. We got most of the gang here at Twitch, but I want to say that we're also seeing you at YouTube. Welcome.
YouTube, what's that?
Okay, so now from this file,
let's get this face card
right here. Sorry, my former dog. Just let's press save as, and near this folder, well, don't create folder, just enter probably one unlocked.
Care trust the lead again? Oh, no, PG Life.
Go to open
jumped over.
Folder, right here.
Oh and no, Huddle Hill got jettisoned over the side. Sorry, Huddle Hill. Wasn't your race this time. I jumped down right after you there. So, well, Care trust just fell. This is a game changer. PG Live up front. Escape from Mars falls off too.
What for?
To edit the file. I will try to
Vox Machina.
Without, I did this very long time ago.
This is bullshit.
That's
awesome.
I think this is VXA file, and I will just try to,
if you can open that with Vox
Edit. PG Live. Let's see how it goes past this bridge. Oh, got stalled by the paddle. Wicked's coming. Wicked's closing the gap. Wicked had a shot at still with the points. Wasn't completely out of it, so this could be big shift.
Gus is looking at
so close.
Damn you.
Yeah.
Screaming about Fox Edit. So there's. I'm going to put the link here.
Oh yeah, PG Live also is in there.
For a mine rail, by the way.
PG Live.
Just for everyone that has tried
taking this race.
Has not seen that move before. So we're trying to open this with the notes.
So
with
this is not
a boost,
file.
Yeah.
Not this file. I,
okay,
indeed,
let's see what happens. Those were 22 points.
So right now, what we want
see.
Is to edit.
I
the
don't know
place,
if that's enough.
Right? The part of the place.
Okay. And number three is PG Live. Number two, Wicked U2. And number one is Karatross. Karatross gets yet another battle card. And yet another golden ticket. This guy is on a marbles winning streak.
It's
some kind of programming language, actually. But
sounds a good race. That's pretty, you know, not too far. Oh, yeah, Wicked was really close behind. Oh, welcome, UO Face 1982.
As you can see, it's
so, should we do another one? What do you think?
So, if in this note editor, we have to just delete, write this text, I hope.
Let's try it. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, so I delete only the text, not the gaps. The gaps are important. So I delete only the text of this equipped blades V2. And I press Ctrl S to save it, or just file and save.
Community maps?
Okay. Node++ is just saying that this file was just modified, and we want to leave it just.
It sucks that this one doesn't auto-scroll.
Yeah.
That's the only thing that sucks about that, in terms of, like, voting.
And we should go just probably home. You don't have to probably save it. I will just do it, yeah. And I will get back to this, this file. Let's just look at it.
It's like you would you'd think they would still scroll.
Maybe we can look at the different pickaxes that were already done there, and we can look how it was done there, or maybe even copy from there.
I opened the open file. So we have this open file.
Yeah, number 7.
I will just select one unlock, and then this one, this file. So
let me scroll down a little bit more.
I did a backup, and I opened a previous file, so that's why it didn't probably work. So
we were not with the unlocked one, okay?
And I hope now it works. No.
All right, they're figuring it out. They're figuring it out. Got it. Actually, go ahead, look over the map. The map list right now.
Here,
I will be right back.
How to unlock this so we can start to get some pickaxes creating? Please help us here. Just right here on the chat, like, guys, you know what? You should be going that way, that direction. You should be doing that.
Okay, maybe I somehow didn't save it, or maybe Notepad didn't save it, or maybe when I press saved I override it. So
let's see if it works. Also, there was a good suggestion here, and Donnie Ann was saying about the glowing blocks. So what about the glowing pickaxe, like a pickaxe that glows in the dark? That would be like the party pickaxe. We could be creating a party pickaxe. It's not something that you see every party.
This name key just keeps getting back. I don't know why, and probably just because I save it somehow. Maybe I will just quit.
Start over. And Srudari is saying, live debugging, let's go. Probably this is not debugging, we're just having technical difficulties.
Well, this is important. So if you want to unlock the file, so this is the first thing that you have to know how to do.
Okay. Live debugging session, let's go. So right now we're trying to unlock the file. So we've opened up the preset. With the preset, we saved a copy of it. And we opened one of those in it's working now. Perfect.
Finally, it's working. I do this very real, not often. I usually have one unlocked. I usually start from just scratch. I don't use the templates. So I'm not very, what's not completely knowing what I'm doing, but I know that I was going in.
You know
that
the logic.
Yeah.
So let's recap. Let's recap what we did. We installed the Voxedit, we opened up the Blades templates. From that Blades template, we created a backup and we made a save file as a backup. Then we went there to that backup and we edited on the Notepad one of those files, right?
Yep. So,
and
the
which
file
one was
menu,
it?
In the, well, for me, it was in my computer name, Voxedit folder, and then
the folder you created, TPM.
It's actually probably deeper than that. I think, as you can see, it's. You cannot see. It's a bit too. I could not zoom this. I don't know, guys. Do you have any problem of unlocking the file?
Just tell us which is the file that we have to open. Maybe we can just go there. So we go to the backup, and it's so small for me, I cannot read it. Goddamn, I need glasses.
So it's
what is it called?
It's called one unlock, how we save the file, the backup, and then it's VXR.
Oh, there's also Endo119 is saying, open templates, save file, create new file, import hierarchy of the new plate. That sounds simpler.
Start hitting exclamation point play.
Okay.
But hey, you know what? It's already done. we don't want to spend too much time just on unlocking the file. Let's build a pickaxe.
Oh, hey, ULA's 19. This is Marbles story. Right now.
It's time to mine.
We're doing some giveaways, taking a break from some of the sandbox.
Yeah, a party pickaxe.
But yeah, what he's saying, because like, I have to check. I'm like, this is driving me crazy too, watching what's going on. I'm like, it's driving me crazy.
We like to go on the hard way, you know. Because
I'm thinking, like, can't you just do almost what Endo just mentioned there.
The good thing is, there's multiple ways to do it.
Okay.
There's not only one way to do it. You can actually do both. So, let's slide away from the head so we can see what...
Yeah, you totally can just import the hierarchy. So like how you're seeing one of the issues that they're having there. Let's say if you make your pickaxe, just make it on the floor. So the center point is like, say if it's the handle, you want it to grab the handle. Make sure the center point of the handle is the center point in your voxedit environment. And then have it sit just below the the
let's
floor.
Put it aside so we can
so
see
like
the
floor would be
the
like where the hand grabs the thing, and then you can import that into your template. No problem. Just go to import hierarchy. Unlink everything, then just click import hierarchy.
Yeah, glowing pickaxe party. So Sandbox is making all these crazy discos and nightclubs. Man, we gotta have a raving pickaxe. People will just
raving pickaxe
glowing and just raving at the party. So what type of color should be this pickaxe? If it is a party pickaxe, what size should it be?
We only have six. What's going on with that? Who are we missing? Caratrust, you better be in there.
What color template
are we going to
use? I
better see Caratrust in there.
Yeah, disco pickaxe.
Well, he did win last time.
Imagine.
So we don't have to join Caratrust. That's fine.
You can use it as a crane for style. You know?
Maybe I should just go. Because look who it is. It's just us.
Like
oh, we spoiled it. Fuck. Oh, hey, there's Mox Machia, though.
See,
that's
well versed enough.
Oh, you're right in there,
Mox. Spin on it.
There's PGR.
You're strong enough to bear with your own weight.
I have no idea about this track. Never played it. So we'll see how it goes.
Or you could just go some hardcore dancing and just flip the pickaxe around while you're at the disco. I don't know. I have not seen many. And
I can see them flipping the pickaxe while they're discoing, yes.
We're in a lot of trouble. Oh, that's probably a hard axe art.
Anyone else?
Axe art dance.
Yeah.
The pink dance. Dance art.
Gonna get going.
Let's make it
work. Get started.
A disco party pickaxe.
Disco party pickaxe.
And
all
what
right.
would be the
That's
color
unique.
Palette? What should we use?
Disco colors.
What would a dwarf want at a
disco?
What would be his colors?
Well, I'm gonna type that in the chat.
If you had to pick some color, a color palette for the disco pickaxe, what would you pick? If you had to go to the disco with a pickaxe, what color should it be?
So,
all right, let's get this one going with our eight. Let's see how this map goes.
A little bit of red, a little bit of shiny, and a little bit of sparkly.
This sparkly.
Red is
making more work for himself. All
like
right,
that.
Ambitious.
So red, shiny, and sparkly. I think we can save the sparkly for the animation.
Ooh, looks like Cottle Hills out in front.
Yeah. Now when we
it does appear that way. This is a pretty fast map. This one's less than a minute on the fastest time globally.
Oh, we got a lot of suggestions here. Okay, so we're going to need
Machina,
a handle,
keeper.
And we're going to need later on the parts. Yeah, it's a big handle, and then the part.
I know it's not something you expect to hear on most streams, right?
And we will
only in the sandbox. Only in the sandbox. Here comes Saddle Hill. Oh, it's going in your favor until that happened.
Right, colors, of course. Through the Rio says purple.
Oh, yeah.
Yellow,
I mean, why wouldn't you bring a pickaxe to the disco, dude? I mean, oh, shit. Someone just got exploded.
That was
PG Live, and me just got exploded.
Green,
oh, no.
Purple,
comes more. Oh, jeez.
Disco ball
carnage.
Again. Yeah.
Carnage.
You know when you have the handle.
Mox Machina.
The grip of the handle, and then
there's
you have
this one.
The, Here, we could That's make a disco fun, ball though. There. That's a great suggestion. So we're starting with the pig.
That was pretty
first.
Fun. Let's see who else. Karatross came in second, Hollow Hill in third.
We just want to make the templates.
I just.
Wicked.
Getting,
making it eventually. It. Nails it. There we go.
So while you get acquainted, with that, I'm going to discuss
those were 10 points for Vox Machina. Got Karatross and 6 more.
Okay, we got.
We'll move on to our next one, which is big dimensional box.
We already got disco ball at the end of the pickaxe. That's a lovely idea. Let's put that into it. Now color palettes. I have to say I'm a bit the purple, yellow, green, and white. Does that remind me of a lot of disco colors? Some 70s vibe, you know? I like that as well. Red would be really bold for a pickaxe, for a party. It could also be glowing. But purple, yellow, and green for sparks, for the animation, for sparkling.
All these wild colors that they're
that must
together.
Turn out really cool as well. We got Martino here at the chat. Welcome. How are you doing today? You have joined just in time to make some pickaxes with us today. So we have just installed the Voxedit, we have unlocked the templates, and right now we are just getting the things ready. This looks more like a broom than a pickaxe right now. It does seem there's a little gap between the handle.
Yeah. I'm just trying to...
Don't forget to exclamation point play in the chat. And that's more marbles, and you get a better vantage point. Whoa, this one looks weird. I like the little panel thingies on the side. I wonder if that's going to come into play or not.
Mm-hmm. Well, we can choose. But that looks...
There we go, got Hollow Hill.
That looks okay.
Cube tap shot.
It hey, doesn't
is,
look
this was our six,
a
I think. Who are we missing?
For the handle.
So,
it doesn't need to be that big. That's a
I'm
giant
just ready to go here. Anyone else?
Yep.
PG Live, he's still there. Got a little more time to get in on this race. This wacky map that we're looking at.
We will fix,
oh, there is Karatross.
Yeah,
there he is.
It's really important just to get the sizes correct. And I'm not
it's
sure
like a moderately timed race here. Fastest time is 1:42.
Well, if you put it in, I would say, half of that.
Let's
see.
Alright. Open up a second Voxedit editor.
Gotta give it a go.
We can.
Here.
That would be perfect, so we can open another pickaxe just
all
for
right.
Comparing.
Let's get this race started.
Let's get the straight how the color palette would be through the pickaxe. Let's use Surdoi Ryu's suggestion. Purple, yellow, green, and white. So we have different parts. We have the handle, we have the grip, we have the
go
end.
Down
so
into this thing.
Ball, and then we're going to have the
then
pick
back up,
and the axe at the other end.
Then back down.
Yeah, it was kind of big. There you can see how smaller it is.
Okay, so it's
35.5. Oh, Vox Machina. Looks like it might be the first out.
Probably you can copy the
ooh, Arc, like escape room artist.
And edit that one.
We can, but...
oh, Doctor Strange,
oh,
TSB.
Yeah, let's switch from,
just
let's
missed
switch
it.
From
we just
scratch,
started
like
not
you
know. Long ago. Yeah, one more race after this.
Yeah, maybe. So, I think that this part is unnecessary.
And I have no idea how this track goes. Okay. I have no... This is the first time we've played this one on the stream. No idea what the hell's going on. But we know Vox Machina is in the lead, I think. Here comes Hoddle Hill. Making a move. On the outside. Oh, nice
smaller.
Nice angle. Oh, gets the boost from the paddle. But Vox Machina, oh man, I got shot through there too. It's going to go back this way. Okay, alright. Confusing. It's confusing.
Blue lava for the axe, yellow clay for
because
the
because Vox getting shot off.
Now,
oh, do the loop-de-loop. That's fun.
Blue lava. Well, I have to
Karatross
say that
just
we
wants
are
all
going
the wins
to
for
have,
himself.
We're in the one of the pickaxes that's scheduled.
Random side.
And it's going to be Rex Roach that's going to design that one. it's a magma pickaxe. So we won't be doing that.
Oh, okay, there's the ending. Alright.
That's already,
it's like Vox Machina.
It's one that's already being made, or being done. We have
just
to
wants
it.
To secure that goblin
okay.
battle card,
so
doesn't he?
Now we've gotten to a new oh, here we go. That we didn't have before, so we have the pickaxe size, so this is 35-45.
Did you get a chance to mint any goblin battle cards, Vox Machina?
Sorry. my phone got message and I started to think in Lithuanian.
Caratros,
yeah,
though,
so
still second. Just does not want
to
relent. That's something that Caratros does not do in his marbles.
We can do this by pressing this.
Let's see what we got. We got a Vox up
yeah.
top.
Yeah, we can see
Caratros in second.
And now we have this, like,
two pairs, you know?
This,
well rigged. Well rigged. Alright, simple rainbow ride. So this is all new to me too. I don't think I've raced these. Or if we have, it's only been like once. Yeah,
this,
we haven't raced this one
oh,
on this channel yet. So.
And
yeah.
probably you have to put it
whoever
lower.
Wins gets a new record
still,
too.
Standing in top of the end. Oh no. No.
We will find it. Yeah, and now I see that in this editor we don't have one feature. So I will get out and save. Yeah.
There's PG Live.
What are you looking for?
There is other editor which allows you to log scope. But you can probably do it with that feature, this feature.
So
yeah.
you're going to, oh, here we go. And let's move them to, there we go.
Okay.
And now they're in the
settle.
Middle.
That's good. Let's,
yep.
let's give ourselves
and
a little vantage point
can,
here.
More blocks. So we have to choose the colors.
Okay.
We have purple, we have
stream.
Yellow, green, and white. Uh-oh.
Yeah,
and there is eight. Going into the final race. Who else do we have just joining us? Dr. Strange, TSB.
I would
TSB.
Say the purple.
So I get in on this race.
Pick, for the pick. Purple and yellow.
Exclamation
and
point
the
player.
Green
good
and
time.
White
how about now?
For the grip and the handle.
Hey, Sparkers
purple,
Nickel.
Purple and white. Actually,
just in time. Play a little marbles.
And, white, and then a green and yellow. Oh, that would look sick. So what if we make the handle green?
We got a little
we
bit of Pickaxe Masters
yellow,
going on here in the background.
And we make the pick purple with white. White shadings.
They're working on a new Pickaxe Live
so,
here. As an example,
is
there is a
green,
contest that they got
the
going
white.
On too,
the hand, yeah, the
and
handle,
they've extended
no,
the
no,
deadline
the
into October.
Green, the grip
so if you do have an idea
yellow.
For a pickaxe, make it and submit it for
the
contest. Might win some sand.
So,
the grip.
This is the grip.
Yeah, that's
standing.
The grip. Yeah. No, let's put that one yellow. The grip.
All right,
we
got nine in this
some,
race. That's good.
After the end and before the hand, so people can actually see the grip. Oh yeah, that would be perfect.
Just to know the colors, I think just to add them. So we have yellow, grip, green.
Okay, let's see. Let's see what's going to happen
probably
here.
Some really
oh, there's Felicia.
This
perfect
this
timing. I was
packs.
Stalling. I knew I was stalling for a good reason.
Maybe that's too much.
Yeah, that's some alien green.
Getting our last race of the
there
Grand Prix here. Winner of this one also gets the goblin battle card. And
what's that
so
flag?
That's fun.
Oh, that's actually Portugal.
Really?
Yeah, green, yellow, red. I was like, what's that flag?
PG Live
yeah,
just stood up and shouted.
Until we get to the big
so.
Part.
All right, let's get this race
and
rolling.
From there it seems, yeah, that
rolling
be,
race,
yeah, but we
rolling
can
marbles.
Later.
Here we roll.
Now,
well,
is it going to be double-sided?
Some more colors.
kind of short race. Fastest time is a little over 1 minute.
Yeah. Let's build firstly the base.
Who we got out first? Yeah, here. Well, it's kind of hard to tell who's out in front. Keratros, so Wicked.
Kind of end we
Fox Machina.
A disco ball.
A disco ball. Okay.
Yeah.
So
Huddle Hill now also.
So I think that maybe this color will.
You add the volume.
Ooh, Keratros just does not want to lose.
For the disco ball, probably yellow again, or white.
For Keratros, it's personal. He's going to win. He wants to win. All he knows is the win.
Oh, you're right.
But Felicia just jumped ahead, so did Vox Machina. So we'll see about that. We'll see about that. Oh, there I went. I'm added to this tally of points for someone else.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's nice of
me. That was dope. So we had that volume,
sound effects too now.
Feature, right? So it was like
yeah,
a
box I got a pretty good lead. The Wicked challenging from the other side. Oh, what's gonna happen here? It's this. Oh, there's portals. Watch out! Oh, portals change it. Everything.
Probably you left.
Set you back further.
Sure.
Oh,
I'm
and Wicked.
Sure will be easier to actually make.
Wicked pulls out the win. Box close behind with
that
second.
Like
oh, people just getting shot right out of the basket with the explosions.
Yeah, but it's not as.
Look at you two gets himself another voxel prize ticket.
Oval.
So that's nice. And then we're gonna
as
see
it
now.
Could be.
We can
who's the winner with the second battle card?
This a bit
it's still exploding in the background.
Which would cost us a lot of nodes.
Mm-hmm.
But it will look much.
Okay.
More
here we go. Battle. Number three
probably
is.
Probably can take the edges.
Look at you too.
The corners.
All right. Number two is. Keratros.
Like
ooh, that means we have a new victor. Who is the new victor? Vox Machina
so
is the victor.
You can take the.
Vox,
probably you can take the corners.
You got yourself.
Well.
Yeah, another golden ticket and.
Yeah,
a goblin battle card. So that's kind of cool. Yeah. Look for that pretty soon. I gotta get these,
really
get this
space,
information
yeah.
over
we
to Batman
space.
ASAP. But I know that it's all part of you know the hype going into the public mint here. So I don't know if you had a chance to mint any of those already, Vox Machina. But if you didn't, here you go, got one. So that's
that
cool.
Is looking better. Yeah.
And if you do got them, you know they're pretty cool. So it's kind of nice to have you know more than one. So that's fun.
Yep, that's about it. And then from there.
But no, I mean, since the Pickback Axe Masters are on, I don't think we should just go ahead and raid them.
I mean,
I've already been at it for a few hours here, and not like necessarily saying, let me go another one. So let's just go ahead and make it official and raid over there.
That looks like it.
And have some fun with them over there. Give some suggestions, make some pickaxes.
Well, I wouldn't.
I know they're fun, aren't they?
In terms of
but thank you everyone for hanging out with me a little longer today on our weekend stream. You know,
looks,
I'm gonna be back tomorrow, probably a little longer weekend stream.
Maybe
we'll
we
see
can
how it goes. You know, we'll see what we'll do. We'll freestyle it. We'll make some
and
more stuff.
Morningstar, that's,
do some more cool
exactly
things.
My yeah, we can
give some more shit away. You know, all that stuff. Yeah, thanks everybody. And hope you enjoyed yourself.
But
and let's go hang out with Pickaxe Masters. See how this disco pickaxe is going to work. Because, you know, we all take our pickaxes to boogie. You know? It's pickaxe.
We can resume it at another time.
That's how I remember.
Maybe.
All right, everyone. Let's go hang out over there. And I'll see everyone soon. Thanks again.
Yeah.